Good morning, students. Today we do lesson 2.3. On page 30, Abdul becomes a courtier. Now this is a little play. It's a small skit, and the characters in this are Abdul and his father. And the main story is about Abdul, who is a simple person who is not very rich. He doesn't have lots of money, but still, how he becomes what he wants to become, and how he is persistent and hardworking. So how hard work and persistence pays off and you get to your goal because of that. Okay, keep your pencils ready because the words are a little difficult, so you need to write the meanings. Father, who is a schoolmaster, is getting ready to go to school. Abdul: Father, to knowledge and erudition I aspire, to study hard and deep books I require. Will you lend me a little gold? Books I'll buy and study to rise high in the world. Now, first line, father to knowledge and erudition. Knowledge means, you know the meaning of knowledge. Erudition means to become a scholar, yes, or not just having knowledge, but being an expert in some field of knowledge, okay. I aspire means I have tried to work hard. This is my aim. I want to become a scholar. To study hard and deep. What does he require to study hard? He requires books. So he's asking his father to lend him some gold. Only the first half of the month has passed, but alas, the money doesn't last. Great books and manuscripts are so expensive. So father is saying only first half means half, 15 days of the month are over, but all the money is over. Whatever salary he got has all got spent within the first 15 days. And great books and manuscripts are very expensive. They are not cheap to buy. Manuscripts are documents with original writing. Remember, this is a skit or a play of olden days. So they used to write by hand. There was no printer. So whatever was written by hand, original work, are called manuscripts. They are very expensive. They are treasures, rare and exclusive. So they are not got anywhere. You have to really go and search for it. So exclusive means they are maybe just one piece. If one person has written, you will have just one book written at a time, okay. But from my school I will try to borrow books that will take you to a brighter tomorrow. Abdul: that will be great. How eagerly I wait. In the evening when father returns. Abdul: how many books could you get? Oh, now my life will be all set. So Abdul is very, very excited because his father has come back and he's sure his father must have brought some books. Now he can start reading. Father: I'm so sorry, son. Couldn't lay my hands on even one. So father is saying, I'm sorry, I couldn't get even one book. Forget about many books for you. Chorus: poor Abdul is sad and dejected. What do you mean by dejected? Is very, what do you say, spirits are down, you know, he's very sad, he's let down. Yes, ponders means thinks. Why my wishes are thus rejected, it's not accepted, rejected means not accepted, continues to do his daily chores. See, now even though what he wishes is not happening, but still he doesn't get angry and sit and sulk in one corner and say, no, I'm not going to do my work, I want to read, and you couldn't even get me one book. No, but he continues to do his work sincerely, in a sincere manner, not just for the sake of doing. Reads books borrowed in tens and scores. So what he does, okay, his father cannot bring, he tries to borrow from whomever he can, and he reads them in many a number. Tens and scores, many a number. An idea that then crosses his mind, to serve the rich and get paid in kind. So he gets an idea, why not work for someone who is rich and then they will pay him in kind. So he will get the money to be able to buy the books. Abdul approaches a rich merchant. Abdul: I'm a poor student. Give me a chance to serve, observe my work, pay only what I deserve. See, Abdul doesn't say, I will work for you, you give me this much salary. He says, I will work. You see how I'm working. If you are happy, only and only then, you give me the salary and you give me the salary as per my work. If you feel I'm good, you give me good salary. If not, you can give me less salary. I will not grumble. I just want to work for you. Merchant, you appear to be smart. Be my clerk. I'll pay you well if honestly you work. So merchant said, you seem to be a smart fellow, because knowing that he's not fixing a particular sum, supposing he fixes a particular amount and he doesn't do any work, that merchant will be paying him just because he has fixed the amount. So here he's very happy to take him, because he says, okay, if he doesn't do work, he will not pay him anything. Yes, or pay him very little. Some days pass. The merchant calls Atul. Merchant, I am pleased with your work and loving care. You are indeed a gem, quite rare. I'll give you a reward if your demand is fair. So when he says, I have found you to be a very hard-working person, and you are very rare, like a gem, because you very rarely find people who work hard nowadays. Yes? So he says, I will give you a reward. You tell me what you want, but it should be something, a proper amount, not any exorbitant amount. Abdul, excited. May I now read the books in your store? Quench my thirst for knowledge. I need more. Quench means satisfy my thirst for knowledge. Since I have already read, but I need to learn more. Chorus. Days passed by. He learned and learned, gaining the knowledge for which he earned. Earned, yearned was he longed for. To yearn means to long for something. Philosophy, astronomy, Arabic and Persian. Philosophy is the study of ideas, of ideology. Yes. Astronomy is a study of the stars. Arabic and Persian are languages. Will he, Abdul the scholar, now in is one in a million. Will he come to the emperor's notice? Will he be given an honorable office? So they are asking, now he has become someone like almost like a learned person. So will the emperor notice him and give him a good post? Friend, news for you, Abdul. The emperor has answered your prayer. The royal Murgi Khana is now under your care. So what is he telling him? The emperor has noticed him, but he's not giving him a post as per his knowledge. He's giving him a post to look after the chickens. You know, Murgi Khana, hen, poultry farm. English word will be poultry farm. So I can ask you, what is the Hindi word? So you write Murgi Khana. English word, poultry farm. So he has to look after all the chickens. Abdul, what? The Murgi Khana for me, a scholar, intellectual, sagacious, astute, made a poultry keeper. Intellectual, you know, smart. Sagacious means wise, W-I-S-E. And astute also means intelligent, someone who uses his knowledge. Yes? Never mind, the chance I won't refuse. It's an opportunity. I'll put it to good use. So he said, doesn't matter. At least I'll get into the king's palace and get to work over there, no matter what the work is. But I will start working with all honesty and all hard work. I will not refuse this opportunity. And so Abdul starts working in the king's palace, but in the Murgi Khana, not as a scholar. Okay, so this is just part one of the lesson. I will do the second part later on. Thank you. I hope you'll have understood, and do read the lesson again. And there are some words which are a little difficult, so read those words again, listen to the video, and I hope you'll have marked the meaning. Thank you.